Good afternoon, everyone. This is Tube 87, and once again, to those who are keeping the Sabbath, I hope you're having a happy and blessed Sabbath. Now, I'm going to spend a few minutes speaking about fear. F-E-A-R, fear. Fear controls so many people's lives that they are being obedient out of fear to the wrong thing or things. And you have to come away from this. Being fearful is nothing but a trick of the enemy. So, with that being said, first of all, let's find out what fear is. Let me give you some definitions. First definition, a feeling of agitation or anxiety caused by the presence of imminent danger. Imminent danger, that something is about to happen to you. Say you're about to be attacked by a snarling dog, or you hear someone breaking into your home. That imminent danger, that type of fear. Secondly, it's a state or condition marked by this feeling. For instance, some people live in fear, that kind of a fear. It's a terrible thing. Third, it's a reason for dread or apprehension. You have people who say things like, being alone is my greatest fear. Some people cannot stand to be alone, so they always have to have someone. Think about relationships. There are plenty of people who do that. Last but not least, it is extreme reverence or awe as toward a supreme power, like to the Heavenly Father. But some people do that to man who are in supreme power, so to speak. So there is a difference there. Now, who was the first one to make this quote? There's nothing to fear but fear itself. Most people who've heard it and are very familiar with it will say FDR, Franklin Delano Roosevelt, make this quote in 1933. That would be accurate, but he wasn't the first one. He borrowed it from a guy named Francis Bacon, who in 1623 wrote it in an essay. And years later, Franklin Delano Roosevelt borrowed it in his inaugural speech. So when people say there's nothing to fear but fear itself, it's a very accurate statement. Fear is another trick of the enemy. People who live their lives fearfully will bend their will to anyone or anything that causes them to be fearful. In fact, the word says in Proverbs 29:25, it reads, go with me there. 29:25, Proverbs reads, it says, the fear of man bringeth a snare, but whoso putteth his trust in the Lord shall be safe. Simple and clear. Those who fear man are setting them up for a trick. There's a trick involved every time. So what the word is saying, we should not be fearful of man. Remember, man can only do so much. But if you live yourself, if you live your life in fear of men, that's who's going to control you. You're not going to focus on the Father. You should live your life in fear of obedience to Him. Now, an example of this is Abraham. If you go with me to Genesis 12:12, Abraham was entering into Egypt. Now, he feared that the Egyptians would take his wife, because one of their practices was that they take the, as scripture calls them, fair looking women, which in terms of scripture, if you were considered fair, you were beautiful. So that's that higher echelon of good looking. You're called fair or exceedingly fair. So that meant beautiful. So Abraham's fear was that the Egyptians would take his wife. Now, if you were married, what they would do is they would kill the husbands so that they would be not stealing someone's wife from them, so they kill them. Six and one half dozen in the other. So he feared that they would kill him because his wife was fair and they would want her. So he wanted Sarah to tell the Egyptians that she was his sister. And that was a trick. As the word says, it ended up being a trick because he deceived the Pharaoh with that lie. But anyway, to make a long story short, what he should have done was to fear the Heavenly Father more than man, the Egyptians. He should have had faith in the Father that he would see him through. Remember, he was already being protected by doing the will of the Father. But yet, at that juncture, he feared man more than he feared the Father in obedience. So it caused him some stress and some other things. So that's an example of why we should always fear the Father. Put our trust in him. Now, the point being, we are to live our lives in fear of obedience to the Heavenly Father and not waver from that. We are not to let the fear of man or what we perceive man can do to us cause us to be disobedient to the Father. This is a test of our faith when fearful things present themselves, especially when it's coming from man, or especially when it's in contradiction to the Father's will. We are to put our trust in him. We are to have faith in him. We're to let him carry us through. We get caught up and start realizing, because we're thinking self, that, hey, I can't get through this situation. Uh-oh, what am I going to do? Now I'm scared. Now I'm fearful. And we start plotting and planning and trying to figure out some way to get out of a fearful situation. We are to turn it over to the Father and not be fearful. Put our trust in him, call in him, and he'll get us through. So, this first part of this video is fear. The next part that I'm going to follow up with is hope. See, because a life without hope is a life full of fear. So, keep that in mind. And remember that the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be obedient. The fear of obedience. Love him. Keep his will. This is 2 of 8, 7. I'm out.